Today we are going to talk about the game football. Football is most popular game in the world and it's played throughout the world in one or the other form. There is hardly any country which is not playing football of one category. The type of football which we are talking is known as association football. The word association football is derived from the word FIFA. FIFA is the controlling body which is giving us this game, under which whose regulation, rules and regulation are being obeyed by the different association of the world. This is the controlling body of the football. In other words, this football is also known as soccer. So, while we are talking about the football, football is a very, very endurance type of game. It requires enormous amount of physical fitness as well as the basic techniques which one must follow. Before talking about the techniques or the other fundamentals, we must know what are the basic aspects which can be considered in the football. Well, running is the basic aspect. We are talking about the running. Here, the running in football is different from that of long distance running. In long distance running, strides are more longer. But here, strides are shorter and the center of gravity is kept near the ground, so that we may change positions at a very small interval. So, running is there, but with small strides. Instead of long strides, only small strides are taken. Now, in running of other categories, which formerly athletes are taking, in that type of running, arm action is also there. That arm action is also sporting there. But here, you are not taking the free actions because you are under the strain or stress, because somebody may tackle, somebody may obstruct your way. That means you are not so free while running as the athletes are there. So, running is there, but that is also under a controlled condition. And at the same time, your strides are very small and you can change position in a very small intervals. So, running is there. Second is change of direction. Football is a game where often you are changing directions. Suppose you are going the forward direction, you are changing direction in the other way. So, changing direction is very common. This can be only possible when you are taking small strides and you are keeping your center of gravity near the ground. Only then you can change the, and at the same time, your foot must have a contact with the ground instead of running on the toes only. Only then you can keep the changing direction possible. So, all of a sudden, player have to proceed forward as well as he have to come back. But coming back and going forward is a continuous process. One has to change. Frequently he has to change position from forward to backward and from side to other side. Their change of direction in a zigzag manner, he too have to move. That means changing of direction is possible, and there is a specific type of changing of direction. Not only the changing of direction just like in other games, here we require specific type of direction change. Now, the third aspect is jumping. Here in football, jumping is having a unique type of jumping process is there. In other type of jumping, we are not taking the cognizance of football. Here we have to take the account of the approach of the football, from where the football is coming, and we have to strike a particular portion of your head, or the you have to, if you are going to trap the ball, even then you have to trap the ball, which ball is coming from the forming an arc, and you are controlling the ball in that position. That means jumping is there, but suppose you want to head and you have to jump it. On jumping is in having a coordination with the flight of the ball. If flight of the ball is coordinating with the type of jump which you are taking, only then you can get maximum benefit of the heading, etc. No, it is very clear that for football, running is there, change of direction is there, and jumping is there. But all these factors are having unique features. They are not the same type of features which we are often coming across in other games. That means running is there, but that is of different nature. Then change of direction is there, that is also of different nature. Again, jumping is there. Jumping is not just a simple type of jumping. We have to coordinate the flight of the ball in jumping too. Now, these are the basic factors in football. Now, still after these factors, there are certain skills which you must have mastery over these skills. Only then you can play the football. There are certain basic skills or fundamentals which you have to master upon these fundamentals. We'll take up all fundamentals one by one. Here in this very episode or in this very lesson, we are going to take up the push pass. Secondly, we'll take up the kicking. This is also a variation of the kicking. Push pass is very common pass in football. If you want to kick the ball in an accurate manner, push pass is very accurate pass. If you want that your ball must reach the accurate person, accurate target, only then you use this pass. This pass is often used in football when you are playing this game. Now, what is push pass? In push pass, there are certain phases in which we can take up the push pass. For this is the type of kicking which is known as push pass. In push pass, first comes the approach. Suppose you want to have a push pass, first phase is known as approach. How to approach the ball? Ball is there, and if you want to come to this ball, you have to come direct in line with the ball. Where you want to kick the ball, your approach must be in line with the ball. And your approach run must be from 3 to 4 yards. Not more than 3 to 4 yards, because it is very stable type of pass, it is very standing type of pass, and at the same time this pass can be done in a running manner. Now approach should be not more than 3 to 4 yards. And when you are approaching the ball, be relaxed and have a stride, first stride should be longer, then come to the ball, then have a slight bend in your knees. And this leg, which is known as this is leg, where your whole body weight is being shared by the this leg, which is parallel with the ball, and the other ball, for example, this is your kicking foot, and in kicking foot you have to turn your foot from a hip, and there should be a slight bend in your knees. You see, there is a bend in knee, and this is turned. Your foot is turned towards your hip side. From hip side, you have to turn. If you are kicking in this direction, you please turn your foot to this direction. And keep your foot back in a turned out position. And have a swing. This is your approach. When you are coming to the ball, then keep your body weight little bit forward. When your body weight will be forward, then this ball is not going to have an arc. It will not take flight. It will reach the target where you want to keep this ball. So, from this position, then comes the striking position. This is the positioning, then striking. Strike the ball in the middle of the portion. From where you have to strike? Striking portion is the this is your foot, and this starts from this very portion, toe to the ankle. This is known as an instep. The whole aspect is known as instep. Kicking is from this very portion, because there is a greater surface area which is striking with the ball, and which gives a greatest impact upon the ball. So that is why this push pass is also known as instep, passing with the instep, because the striking area, the contact area is greater. Only then this starts from this and comes to this. Yes, you see here, this is evident from the picture. This starts from this, and the middle portion of your foot starting from toe to the heel, this portion is known as instep. We are striking this portion with the ball. And if you want that your ball should go on the ground, then try to strike in the middle of the ball. Only then ball can go on the ground. If this ball is striking just below the center of the ball, then ball will take an arc. If you are striking your foot with this very portion, then this ball is not taking any speed. So there is no use of taking this type of kick. You have a contact in the middle or lower, as the position as you want to send the ball should go. This is the striking position. Striking is there. Then while striking the ball, your joints must not be loose. Losing the joints will not produce greatest impact upon the ball. That means your strikes must be having some force in it. Then straighten your leg and have a proper strike, and after striking the ball, you must be clear about the thing that it must have a follow through. The direction in which you want that your ball should move, your follow-up action should be also in the same direction. Only then this pass is possible. Otherwise, what will happen? If you are striking the ball in the, not in the center and striking with the other portion, then it will take a swing. And your that purpose, very purpose of giving accurate ball will be forfeited. When you want that your ball must strike in a center and must reach the target, your ultimate aim is to give a best pass. Best pass is that which can be received in a proper manner by the receiver itself. There is no difficulty in receiving the ball. That pass is known as best pass. Otherwise, what happened? You can pass, but that pass is having other direction. If your pass is taking other directions or it is taking bounces, then what is the use of this pass? That means we are wasting our energy and the skill. So, this pass is very, very helpful in the event of accuracy, when you want that your ball must reach in an accurate manner, then this pass is very, very helpful. Now, I think this concept is quite clear, but if you find that something is missing, then we can take it again. Now, I'll take it the entire in a very, very wholesome manner. First comes the approach, how to approach the ball. If your approach is proper, be sure that you are striking the ball in a proper direction. If your approach is defective, then the results cannot be obtained in a better manner. Your approach should be 3 to 4 yards. And there should be a bend in the knees, and first stride should be larger, and keep your this non-kicking foot in parallel with the ball, and kicking foot must be having outward turn. Only the portion which is known as instep must be there. I have told you what is instep. Instep is the portion starting from the toe to the ankle, and that must be striking with the ball. Only then you can have a proper kick. This is about the push pass. Now, this is, suppose you have kicked the push pass. There is other variation, how to receive the ball. This is also in the same manner we are taking the ball from other persons. If ball is coming on the ground or coming with a small height, only then you can receive the ball. The receiving of the ball is a different skill. Now, here the approach is from this side. On receiving the ball, this starts from the other side. If your ball is having a flight, for example, your ball is here, it is coming to this very direction. Then keep your foot forward in the same position, have a slight bend in the knee, and twist your foot forward, and it should come little bit further. Flight of the ball is there, and meet the ball in the air and come with a cushion effect. Give it a cushion effect to the ball. Here ball is coming and striking this, then the ball is being kept here and there, and then this ball will come over here. The velocity of the ball, the force of the ball will be diminished and you will not be hit by the ball. As in cricket, you might have noticed people are meeting the ball above the head and taking the ball to the chest. In the same way, we are meeting the ball at the body and bringing the ball with near the body, and even after that there is a longer contact of the body. This reduces the force, this absorbs the force of the ball, and ball comes under your control. This is known as the receiving of the ball. That means, no doubt, push pass is also there, and receiving the ball is equally important. If your ball is received properly and ball is under control, only then there is any utility of this pass and receiving the ball. If sometime what happened, people are receiving the ball and they are keeping their limbs in a very tight position. After striking the foot, the ball goes away. That means there is no control over the ball. Our sole aim is to have a proper control of the ball. Therefore, this pass is often used in the football, and most common pass is there.